You know that God has established the church. That word is very curious, church. You know, many deaf people hate that word, church. Really, it's kind of wrong sign church, you know, because most of the time what we mean by church is a building, you know, wood, brick, steeple, cross on the top, church, like a building. But really, when the Bible talks about the word church, it really should be signed church people or God's people. That's the real church. The building is not the church. You know, in the Bible, God says, I refuse to live in a place that people build. In the Old Testament, God wouldn't allow saws and hammers and different things inside the temple. Everything had to be made outside of the temple, then brought in. Often in the Old Testament, altars were not made of wood. They were made of stones, because stones put on top represented only what God made. God made stones. People never make stones. And so altars were built for that, they were built that way because they represented God's work. Well, it's the same with the church. When I sign church people, God is not interested in the building. He is interested in living where? He is interested in living in a place he himself makes. And his special creation, you remember Adam and Eve. God is interested in living in people's hearts, living in people's minds. That's the true building of God inside people. The Bible says, your and my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. It means God wants to come and live in us, in our spirits. He wants to be connected to us. And so when we talk about the church, we're not talking about the church building. We're talking about the people that believe in God, that come together, that worship Him. And God wants people to come among the church, because the church is the place where the forgiveness of sins is provided. You remember that Jesus told Peter, or he questioned Peter, he said, who do people say that I am? And Peter said, well, some say you're a prophet that's come back to life, Elijah or John the Baptist or something. And then Jesus asked them, who do you, Peter, my disciples, my friends, who do you say that I am? And Peter answered with what? He said, thou art the Christ, the Son of God. You are the living Christ. And Jesus said, blessed are you, Peter, because people didn't show you that. God put it in your mind. And Jesus said, from now on, this will be people that belong to me, people that confess the same thing, that I am the Christ, the Son of the living God. That's the church. Jesus said, right, and Jesus said, now I give you the key. The key, you know, keys are important. If you lose the keys to your car, you can't drive anymore. If you lose the key to your house, you can't get in without breaking something. Jesus gave all of the disciples, all of the church, the keys of what? The forgiveness of sins. Jesus said, here is the key. The things that you want that are good, let them go free. They will be free in heaven. Things like joy, peace, love, kindness, mercy, help. Those things we want to be free. But the bad things we want to lock up. The bad things, rape, murder, hatred. Those bad things we want to keep locked. We don't want them out. We want them to be closed off. That's why Jesus gave us the church. We can forgive sins, or we can keep sins. What's the goal? The goal is the same as Jesus. Jesus came to forgive sins. That's why he came. Jesus said, I came not into the world to judge the world, to condemn the world. No, I came into the world that they might be saved. And so we come to the church, not the building. We come to the church. For what? To receive preaching of his word, the information about Jesus and Jesus' love, his death on the cross, his resurrection, his ascension, his coming again to bring us home into heaven. We come to church to receive baptism, the washing clean of your sins, to receive the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. We come to the church to receive the Lord's Supper, the true body and true blood of Jesus. Jesus has even established in the church, not the building, but in the church, he established what? Pastors and teachers and evangelists and various people that help to teach Jesus. Why? Because Jesus loves us. He wants to live in us. God refuses to live in a building that we build. He won't do it. But he will live in us. He will live in the church. Thanks be to God for the blessings he gives to his church.